You've got 10 seconds, which is impossible.
So basically, 10 seconds, you're dead.
In Indonesia, a passenger jet carrying 189 people crashed into the sea near the capital of Jakarta shortly after it took off Monday morning.
In recent years, it feels like we've been hearing about plane crashes more often.
An Ethiopian Airlines flight has crashed shortly after takeoff from Addis Ababa.
Our next story is from South Korea, where a disaster has taken place. A plane crash that has left 179 people dead,
killing all 157 passengers and crew thought to be on board.
It's the worst air disaster on South Korean soil.
Why did they crash? Were the pilots somehow at fault? Or something fundamentally wrong with the planes themselves?
Something was putting repeated nose-down pressure on the airplane.
The bottom line here is the 737 MAX is safe.
On October 29, 2018, Lion Air Flight 610 took off from Soekarno-Hatta International Airport in Indonesia with plans to land at Depati Amir Airport, Pangkal Pinang. It was an ordinary Monday morning. The 737 MAX 8 jet lifted off at 6:20 a.m., carrying 189 souls, each with a story, dreams, and plans for the future. But just 12 minutes after takeoff, something went horribly wrong. Communication with the plane was lost, and soon after, plane crashed into the Java Sea.
Where a Lion Air jet with 189 people on board fell into the sea minutes after takeoff, leaving no survivors,
killing all 189 people on board.
Families had gathered here at Jakarta Airport to find out the fate of their relatives.
During the 11-minute flight, the pilots fought the downward tilt more than two dozen times until finally losing control and crashing into the Java Sea at 450 miles per hour.
The aviation world was rocked to its core. Yet, this was only the beginning. Fast forward to March 10, 2019, less than 5 months later. Ethiopian Airlines Flight 302 was set to make a routine trip from Addis Ababa to Nairobi. The plane, another 737 MAX 8, took off at 8:30 a.m. local time. But within minutes, alarms were ringing in the flight deck. The pilots noticed the plane behaving erratically. And then, the familiar, horrifying pattern emerged. A sudden, uncontrollable nosedive. 6 minutes after takeoff, the plane disappeared from radar.
Tonight, global grief and so many questions about what brought down Ethiopian Airlines Flight 302, 157 people all lost.
Flight 302 had crashed into a field in Gimbuchu, Ethiopia, killing all 157 people on board. Families around the globe mourned their loved ones, as once again, the same haunting name was tied to a catastrophe, Boeing 737 MAX. Once the news hit, people were stunned.
Boeing faces a lot of safety questions this morning because this is the second crash in just 5 months involving their...
The global aviation community acted swiftly. Within days of the Ethiopian Airlines crash, 51 aviation regulators grounded the Boeing 737 MAX. It began with China, where aviation authorities banned the MAX from flying within their airspace just a day after the disaster. Then, a domino effect followed.
Several countries and airlines announced Monday they are grounding Boeing 737 MAX 8 planes.
Australia, UK, Singapore, nation after nation grounded the jet, sending a loud and clear message. They no longer trusted the 737 MAX. The issues don't end there.
We are emergency. We are depressurized. We do need to return back to. We have 177 passengers.
Those were the chilling words of the pilot of Alaska Airlines Flight 1282 after disaster struck midair. On January 5, 2024, just 20 minutes into the flight and cruising at 16,000 feet above the ground, a door plug covering a non-operational emergency exit suddenly flew off. It left a gaping hole in the plane, forcing the crew to declare an emergency landing. Imagine being a passenger on that plane as it happened. For 117 passengers on board that flight, that was their reality. Fortunately, this time, there were no injuries or fatalities. But it was yet another reminder of the growing concerns surrounding Boeing aircraft. By the end of 2024, over 12 reported incidents involving Boeing aircraft had occurred. But the deadliest came just days before the new year, on December 29th in South Korea. A Jeju Air Boeing 737-800 was attempting to land at Muan International Airport. Instead of a safe landing, disaster struck. The plane, unable to deploy its front landing gear, went off the runway, hit a concrete fence, and burst into flames. The crash killed 179 passengers and crew, a devastating end to the year for Boeing and aviation safety as a whole. Early investigations pointed to possible causes like bird strikes or landing gear malfunctions, but nothing has been confirmed yet. What was certain, however, was South Korea's response. Officials swiftly ordered safety inspections for every Boeing 737 operated in the country, a decision that underscored the rising distrust of Boeing's aircraft. Two 737 MAX disasters, emergency landings, mechanical failures, fatal crashes, it all begs the question, what's wrong with Boeing? This is the company that once stood as a symbol of innovation, reliability, and dominance in the skies. So, how did it come to this? How did the most trusted name in aviation become linked to fear, controversy, and failure? To truly understand Boeing's downfall, we need to take a step back and look at the bigger picture. Boeing, founded by William E. Boeing in Seattle in 1916, quickly became a global symbol of innovation and engineering excellence. Known for designing and manufacturing advanced aircraft, it revolutionized air travel with the iconic models like Boeing 737s and 747. The 737, often considered Boeing's flagship product, became one of the most recognizable planes in the world, setting the standard for commercial aviation with its exceptional convenience and safety. Meanwhile, the 747, introduced in 1969, was a marvel of its time, twice the size of other planes, making global travel more accessible and affordable. These iconic designs solidified Boeing's role as a pioneer in aviation, captured in the famous phrase, "If it's not Boeing, I'm not going," bringing the world closer together. But even the strongest reputations can falter. In 1997, Boeing, still a powerhouse of engineering brilliance, merged with McDonnell Douglas in a $30.1 billion deal, one of the largest in aerospace history. Boeing dominated commercial aviation, while McDonnell Douglas specialized in military contracts. On paper, the merger looked like a strategic win to strengthen Boeing's position across industries. But behind the scenes, it set the stage for a cultural and operational shift that would slowly erode Boeing's identity and, ultimately, its reputation. Before the merger, Boeing was an engineering-first company, renowned for its innovation and quality. McDonnell Douglas, however, operated with a profit-first mentality. This cultural clash became the foundation for Boeing's transformation, one that many critics argue led to its decline. After the merger, Boeing's leadership made drastic changes. Under the influence of Harry Stonecipher, a McDonnell Douglas insider, Boeing began prioritizing shareholder value over engineering excellence. Stonecipher openly admitted, "When people say I changed the culture of Boeing, that was the intent. So it's run like a business rather than a great engineering firm." Thousands of jobs were cut, and in 2001, Boeing's headquarters moved from Seattle to Chicago. While this decision earned the company a $60 million tax credit, it created a significant divide between executives and the engineers who actually designed and built the planes. In a company like Boeing, there needs to be a balance between the executives who try to make the money and the engineers who try to deliver a good product. This balance was lost as profit took priority over quality, leading to a dramatic cultural shift. Boeing's once engineering-driven culture began to erode. Employees reported a stark change in priorities, with design meetings increasingly centered on stock prices rather than technical excellence. Engineers faced relentless pressure to cut costs and meet aggressive deadlines, often compromising quality in the process. Reports of declining standards started to emerge. Whistleblowers described a toxic work environment where quality concerns were ignored, and documenting defects was actively discouraged. One employee recalled,
"I did have one manager that worked with me back in the, he recorded all the aircraft and what was wrong with them and what they were sending out the back door that hadn't been fixed. And the director of quality told him, I don't want any more of these papers or any more of these pictures sent to me."
Boeing's shift away from prioritizing safety and quality proved devastating for the company and its reputation. Rather than investing in entirely new aircraft designs, Boeing adopted a cost-saving strategy, modifying older models. This decision, driven by a desire to maintain profitability, would backfire in the face of rising competition. In the early 2000s, Boeing's dominance in the aviation industry faced a new threat: Airbus. By 2003, the European manufacturer overtook Boeing in market share. Then, in December 2010, Airbus launched the A320neo, a revolutionary aircraft with a fuel-efficient design that set a new standard in the industry. The A320neo was an instant success. Within a single week, Airbus sold an incredible 667 planes, a number that outpaced Boeing's 737 sales for an entire year. Boeing didn't have a plan to compete, so they scrambled to catch up. Instead of developing a new aircraft from scratch, the company made a fateful decision to modify its aging 737 design. The result was 737 MAX, a plane rushed to market to compete with Airbus's A320neo. But this quick fix came with severe trade-offs. Launched in 2011, the 737 MAX featured larger, more fuel-efficient engines to match Airbus's A320neo. However, these engines were heavier and had to be mounted further forward on the fuselage. This altered the plane's aerodynamics, causing the nose to pitch upward under certain conditions. To address this issue, Boeing implemented the Maneuvering Characteristics Augmentation System, MCAS, an automated software designed to stabilize the aircraft. On paper, MCAS seemed like an easy solution, but there was a fatal flaw. Boeing didn't tell its existence to pilots, and the system relied solely on a single sensor, the angle of attack sensor. If this sensor malfunctioned, MCAS could trigger a relentless nosedive. Without any knowledge of MCAS or guidance in the plane's manual, pilots were left unprepared to handle such failures. This decision ultimately led to two of the most devastating crashes in aviation history: Lion Air Flight 610 in October 2018 and Ethiopian Airlines Flight 302 in March 2019. Both crashes were caused by a common thread: faulty AOA sensor readings. These readings triggered MCAS, forcing the planes into uncontrollable nosedives that the pilots were unable to counteract. 346 lives were lost as a result. In fact, these crashes didn't have to happen. Engineers and pilots have pointed out that the aircraft flew perfectly well, but its handling was slightly different from older models. Boeing could have required additional pilot training to address these differences, but that would have been costly and time-consuming for airlines, a risk Boeing wasn't willing to take. Instead, Boeing used MCAS to make 737 MAX handle like its older models, avoiding the need for expensive pilot retraining. It was a calculated move designed to save money, but it came at the expense of safety, a gamble that ended in unimaginable tragedy. Making matters worse, Boeing's actions were largely unchecked by the Federal Aviation Administration. It was during this time that the under-resourced and underfunded FAA was relying heavily on Boeing to regulate itself. Boeing took advantage of this trust, removing MCAS from operation manuals and downplaying its significance. In its relentless pursuit of profit, Boeing's reputation for safety, once its greatest asset, began to crumble. The warning signs were everywhere. Boeing technicians reported debris left near electrical wiring, loose and defective parts. Shockingly, Boeing's own technicians refused to board their own planes. On top of this, critical engineering tasks were outsourced to contractors earning as little as $9 an hour, a decision that further eroded standards. The consequences were harrowing. In 2011, passengers in a Boeing 737 flying from Phoenix to Sacramento were rocked by a terrifying incident.
The last thing you want to see when you are in a plane at 36,000 feet, the sky through the roof of the plane.
A 5-foot hole suddenly ripped open its roof mid-flight. The incident was blamed on extremely poor manufacturing technique. The most recent incident, on January 5, 2024, involved Alaska Airlines Flight 1282. Just 20 minutes into the flight, at 16,000 feet, a door plug designed to seal an emergency exit blew off, leaving a gaping hole in the aircraft. An NTSB investigation revealed that Boeing had failed to secure the door with 4 critical bolts, a glaring oversight that could have turned fatal if the plane had climbed higher. Given everything we've uncovered, what do you think caused Boeing's downfall? Was it the shift to chasing profits over safety, weak regulations, or the pressure to keep shareholders happy? The truth is, Boeing, once a symbol of trust and innovation, lost its way. But this isn't just about one company. It's about a system where profit often comes before accountability. And it leaves us with a tough question: how many lives are we willing to risk in the name of profit?